Hello and welcome to TI's Precision Labs, an online video curriculum for engineers. This Precision Lab video will address some common questions about reinforced and basic isolation. For more Precision Lab topics on isolation, you can visit www.ti.com/precisionlabs. This video will review the following topics. What is isolation voltage? What is basic isolation? What is reinforced isolation? And answer the question, are all 5 kV isolators reinforced isolators? Systems with voltages of greater than 50 volts DC or 25 volts AC are considered to have hazardous voltages. For these systems, industry standards require isolation voltage certification for safety. What is isolation voltage? Isolation voltage is the highest amount of voltage that can be applied across an isolation barrier without compromising the integrity of the isolation barrier. Across isolation technology types of optocouplers and digital isolators, the critical tests used to determine isolation voltage ratings are withstand voltage, partial discharge, and surge testing. Surge testing is the most stringent of these isolation tests, where a 10 kV predefined surge pulse waveform is applied directly to the component. The terms functional, basic, and reinforced are common terms used to describe the categories of isolation voltage ratings. For isolation components, the ratings of basic and reinforced are most frequently used and describe whether a device offers single protection or the equivalent of double protection. What is basic isolation? Basic isolation provides a single layer of isolation protection against electrical shock as long as the insulation barrier is intact. This means that if the isolation barrier is breached, no additional barrier of protection remains. To receive the rating of a basic digital isolator with the surge test, the component must pass the surge test at 1.3 times their isolation rating. Basic isolators commonly have isolation ratings of 2.5 to 3 kV, but in some cases a basic device may have an isolation rating of up to 5 kV. High voltage systems require basic isolation to be supplemented with a secondary isolation barrier for redundancy to provide added shock protection in the event that the first barrier fails. This is called double isolation. Circuit designers can use two basic isolation components in series to achieve double isolation, or choose a certified reinforced isolation component. What is reinforced isolation? Reinforced isolation components may offer a single isolation barrier, but they must have the proven high voltage electrical strength, reliability, and shock protection equivalent to double isolation, or two levels of basic isolation. A reinforced rated digital isolator must pass the surge waveform test at 1.6 times the rated isolation voltage, but must also have a certified surge rating of 10 kV or greater. Reinforced digital isolators commonly have isolation ratings of 5 kV or greater and surge ratings of greater than 10 kV. There are multiple standards that define the conditions of test for a reinforced isolator. For digital isolators, the VDE 08840-11 standard is the current standard at the time of this video and the most commonly used for digital isolators. To determine if the digital isolator you're considering meets the isolation standards required for your system, the certification numbers and conditions should be provided to you by the manufacturer. If the proof of certificate cannot be provided, the component may not meet the safety requirements of your end equipment standard. Are all 5 kV isolators reinforced isolators? While most reinforced digital isolators have a rating of 5 kV or higher, isolators can be rated for 5 kV isolation protection and not necessarily be reinforced isolators. This is because in order to achieve a reinforced rating, isolators must pass the surge test at 10 kV and must also maintain package creepage and clearance requirements, conditions for repetitive peak voltage, climate, and material and pollution groups. All conditions of test must be met in order to achieve the VDE certification. While isolation rating is determined by surge test results, achieving a reinforced rating requires that additional conditions be met. Because the conditions of test are a critical part of achieving reinforced rating, not all devices that have a 5 kV isolation rating are reinforced. To identify which devices are reinforced rated, the certificate and conditions of test should be reviewed. This concludes a brief introduction to basic versus reinforced isolation. To learn more about isolation devices and isolation designs, please visit www.ti.com/precisionlabs. Please take the online quiz. This digital isolator claims reinforced isolation and an isolation rating of 5 kV, which at a multiplier of 1.6 times for surge equates to 9 kV, not the 10 kV reinforced requirement. Is this device really reinforced? It is common for multiple devices within a family of isolators to share a common data sheet, but reinforced ratings will only apply to the devices that meet all of the reinforced requirements and are specified in the certification. The VDE condition of test requires the device to meet the surge spec in oil, where there is no limitation of package or clearance. This is a barrier level test. To maintain this rating, the device must also meet the creepage and clearance requirements that will perform as reinforced. A 10 kV surge may be met because of the clearance being greater than 8 mm in one package, but when placed into an alternate package, only greater than 4 mm clearance, and the device would no longer meet the 10 kV surge spec. For this reason, close attention to packaging and conditions of certification are required. Thank you for watching. You can learn more about TI's isolation portfolio at www.ti.com/isolation.